Good morning, everybody. Can you hear me all right? Is the microphone on? Is it working? Is the sound system on? Is this testing? Does it sound like it's working? Is it? It is sitting on. Morning to those of you watching on Facebook. I think the camera's a bit wonky actually this morning. Apologies. Are we on now? Testing? Testing. Oh, one, two. Is that going? Is that on? It should be on. Doesn't seem to be working. Okay. Well, hopefully you can hear me anyway. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
It's that old joke about the bishop that goes to a church and he taps on the microphone and he says, "There appears to be something wrong with this microphone." And everybody says, "And also with you." Boom, boom. Terrible joke. I'm lovely to see you this morning for the feast of the celebration of Corpus Christi, which is a thanksgiving and a focus on what Holy Communion is all about. We didn't sort of celebrate it in full last year because, of course, we were still kind of in lockdown and not able to gather for communion, and it felt a little bit difficult to sort of celebrate communion when we weren't able to visit each other, but I thought we would celebrate it today, and that means that I can carry on wearing white instead of green. I get a bit bored when, because after this it's green for ages. It's ordinary time for a long time, so it's a festival today of Corpus Christi. Just a quick reminder, please do stay after the service. We've got our annual meeting. We had our last annual meeting literally just before lockdown, so it's been a bit of a year, hasn't it? but it's exciting because we're going to be electing some new members onto our PCC, a new church warden and so on. Hopefully the meeting won't be any more than half an hour if I can shut up long enough to get us through it quickly. So please do stay after the service for that meeting so that we can do that important business of the church. We've also got a very important task this morning as part of that meeting, and do please stay behind for that, is that we've got three people who are retiring from very important roles in the church, and we want to thank them. So please do stay for the meeting to thank Pat Hall for being an amazing PCC secretary, Vernon Sanderson for serving as church warden for 7 years for us, and David Higgins, who's been an absolutely fabulous treasurer to us as well. I think actually, let's give them a round of applause now. So that we can give them a really special thank you for all their efforts over the last few years, and also to elect their replacements as well. I think that's basically my main note. Oh, the other thing to say is that the curate moved into his house on Friday. He lives in Clough, just off Mansfield Road, and he just wanted me to say he was overwhelmed by the welcome hamper that we did for him. So thank you to everyone who contributed to that, and I think he feels very made to feel welcome. And Paul and I are going to take him for lunch today, and hopefully he'll settle in well. So do think about him as he settles into a new place here in Barlborough Parish, and he's going to be ordained deacon on the 26th of June. So do be praying for him. And I've got a nice job of publishing some vows of marriage. Now these are for the granddaughter of Ron Faith at Clown Church. So those of you watching online from Clown will know this family well, so looking forward to doing their wedding at Clown. It will be a lovely celebration. So I published the banns of marriage between Stephen Mark Bingham and Rebecca Maria Rose, both of the parish of Clown. This is for the first time of asking. If any of you have a reason in law why these persons may not be joined in holy matrimony, you are to declare it now. So let's pray for this couple. Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing Stephen and Rebecca together. We pray that their marriage will be life-giving and lifelong. Be with them as they prepare to get married later this year. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, and the final quick thing to say is that a new edition of The Upper Room is out. I have brought some in envelopes, and they're at the back. Some of you will have taken them already with addresses on them, so that I could save on the postage. So do pick one up before you go if it's got your name on it. If you can't find one with your name on, and you usually get it, it'll come in the post. Okay? So do pick up one of those. And inside is a list of all the services up to the end of September, just so that you can keep track of what's happening. Okay. And thank you to Reese for playing the organ for us today. So if you wouldn't mind playing the game, that would be great. I'm going to walk in that way. Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. So together we recognise that God is already here. He is closer to us than breathing. And we come into his presence. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we take a moment to consider how we have been this week, how we've been with other people, and how we've been with God. You then, who truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbours, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from this day forward in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God. Like as the heart longs for flowing streams, so longs my soul for you, O God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O send out your light and your truth, that they may lead me. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
May we come to your altar, O God, the God of our salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord enrich you with his grace and nourish you with his blessing. The Lord defend you in trouble and keep you from all evil. The Lord accept your prayers and absolve you from your offences for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Saviour.
Amen.
Please stand as we say the Gloria together. Can't wait till we can sing this again, actually. Anyway, let's say it with as much gusto as we can. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God, Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you that in this wonderful sacrament you have given us the memorial of your passion. Grant us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood.
first reading this morning is from Genesis chapter 14, reading from verse 18. And King Melchizedek of Salem brought out bread and wine. He was a priest of God Most High. He blessed him and said, "Blessed be Abraham by God Most High, maker of heaven and earth, and blessed be God Most High, who has delivered your enemies into your hand." And Abraham gave him one tenth of everything. The second reading is from the first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 23. "For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, it is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup also, after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.'" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel reading. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died, but the one who eats this bread will live forever." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Tell you three different stories today. Two are true and one is fictional. All of them are to help us reflect on the power of the gift of Holy Communion that we celebrate on this day, the Feast of Corpus Christi, which means the body of Christ. So the first story. There was a woman who became an Anglican in the 1940s, and she was dating a young guy from the Baptist tradition, and she took him to her church. Both of them were African American, and everyone in the church was white. This was in the 1940s in the segregated heart of America. When she went to communion, he sat in the pew, because in those days, if you were Baptist, you didn't take communion in an Anglican church and vice versa, so he remained in his seat. She went up to take communion, and she was the only black person in the congregation, and he waited to see what would happen, because not only were they taking the bread, but he noticed that they were all drinking from the same cup. And he had never seen black folk and white folk drink out of the same cup or from the same water fountain. So she went up to take communion, and the priest came giving out the bread, saying, "The body of Christ, bread of heaven. The body of Christ, bread of heaven." And then the priest came along with the chalice, "The blood of our Lord Jesus Christ given for thee. Preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Drink this in remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee." And he got to the black woman, "The blood of our Lord Jesus Christ given for thee, preserve thy body and soul." And that man watching said, "Any church where black and white drink from the same cup has discovered something that I want to be a part of and that the world needs to know about." That man and that woman were the parents of Bishop Michael Curry, the man that gave the sermon at Meghan and Harry's wedding, you'll remember, a few years ago. He says of this, "This is the sacrament of unity that can overcome even the deepest estrangements between human beings." Second story. A few years ago, when I was a curate, I got a sad phone call from an elderly congregation member to tell me that her daughter, who was only in her 40s, had died of cancer. I knew that I had to go and visit her immediately. But what do you say to someone who has lost their daughter? There are no words, but I know from my own personal experience, and I'm sure you do as well, that you need something beyond words at a time like that. As a priest, my instinct was immediately to take Maureen the sacrament. So I got my home communion set together, collected the Blessed Sacrament from church, bread and wine, and took it to Maureen's house. When I arrived, I carefully laid out the white cloth on her table, lit two candles, and placed the bread and wine in their silver vessels on the table. And we said the prayers, those comforting prayers from the Book of Common Prayer together, and we shared bread and wine. And I knew that that, and not any words, was what she needed. Jesus came to her that day in the bread and wine, a reminder that Jesus himself died young, that Jesus knows what suffering is, that Jesus is with us in his suffering, and that every time we eat the bread and drink the cup, we proclaim his death, and also a reminder that we will be raised with him. It is a meal of hope, as well as sometimes being a meal of pain. I gave Maureen a blessing and left her with her own thoughts. Nothing but the Eucharist could have consoled her that day, and I prayed a prayer of thanks to God for the gift of the Eucharist that day. It spoke to Maureen where I couldn't. The third story. Some of you might have seen the BAFTA award-winning TV programme on the BBC starring Sean Bean called Broken, came out a few years ago. It's a programme about a Roman Catholic priest working in a poor city in the northwest. In one of the episodes, a policeman who has seen a terrible miscarriage of justice is a member of Father Michael's congregation. He is stuck between a rock and a hard place, not knowing whether to tell the truth and risk losing his job, or to lie to protect his colleagues and his own job so that he can provide for his one-year-old daughter. Andrew goes to speak to Father Michael, and after to-ing and fro-ing, tells Father Michael that he can't bring himself to tell the truth. He's going to have to lie. The next scene, we see people gathered at Mass, and the line is formed of people coming forwards to receive communion. At the back of the church, there is Andrew, in the back pew with his head in his hands. Eventually, Andrew joins the back of the line. And as he gets to the front, he looks up at Father Michael, who looks into his eyes, and then quietly says, "The body of Christ," placing the host into Andrew's outstretched hands. Later, Andrew knocks on the presbytery door, and Father Michael opens it. Andrew has clearly been crying, and he says, "Why did you give me communion, Father?" Michael replies, "Why do you think I gave it to you?" And Andrew says, "Because I've never needed it so much in my life." Michael replies, "That's why I gave you it." In a similar way to my experience with the grieving Maureen, Andrew was in a situation that could not be dealt with in words alone. He needed God and met with God in the Eucharist. It is often at those times when life is most desperate that we need not words, but actions. Not words, but something beyond that. That is what Holy Communion offers to us. As the old Book of Common Prayer service says before the bread and wine is distributed, "Come to me, all who labour and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." So as you come to receive communion today, as you put out your hands, come with all your burdens and exchange them for the bread, the very presence of Jesus himself. Jesus knows all the secrets of your heart, knows all the burdens that you are carrying. As you receive the bread, you take Christ into your very self, his love, care, protection, and sharing in your suffering. The word Eucharist literally means thanksgiving. In modern Greek, the word for thank you, I don't know if anyone knows how to say thank you in Greek, but it's ευχαριστώ, so don't think anyone's going to have a holiday in Greece very soon, but it's one for the future anyway. Ευχαριστώ, and it's from exactly the same root, as the, it's basically the same word as Eucharist. An E and a U together are pronounced F in modern Greek. Today, we give thanks for the gift of the presence of Christ in the bread of heaven. And so let us open up ourselves to encounter him again today. Amen. So please, would you stand as you are able as we declare our faith in the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please sit or kneel as we come to pray. Pray to the Lord. Lord, listen to the prayers of your people gathered at your table. In faith we pray. We pray to you, our God. Here, where we celebrate how Christ gave us his body to be our spiritual food, listen as we pray for his body, the Church, spread throughout the world. We pray especially for those Christians who are persecuted for their faith, who have communion services in secret, who live in fear for their lives. We pray for all those churches adapting because of the pandemic. May they know your presence with them. In faith we pray. We pray to you, our God. Here where we recognize the presence of Christ, who takes away the sin of the world, listen as we pray for that world and for its peoples for whom his blood was shed. We pray for peace in our world. We pray especially for the Holy Land and for the political situation in Israel-Palestine, that there may be hope and peace to come. We pray for the meeting of the G7 this week, praying that decisions will be made that will help the poorest. And we we pray for those nations who are really struggling with the pandemic, especially thinking of India. And we pray for our own nation as we emerge from the pandemic. We pray for deep wisdom for those making life and death decisions. In faith we pray.
We pray to you, our God.
Here where we come together as Christ gathered with his friends to give us this meal of holy fellowship, listen as we pray for all whom you have given us, our friends and all whose lives are joined with ours. So in a moment's quiet, we'll bring before God our friends and family and those closest to us. In faith we pray.
We pray to you, our God.
Here where we remember the night of Christ's agony and triumph, listen as we pray for all who share his sufferings through pain, fear or pain or distress of many kinds. And we pray especially by name for Wyatt and Garrett Ruthven, Barbara Needham, Veronica Blackwell, Margaret and Jim Gilmore, Luke Firth, Chloe Parks, Betty Wood, Jean Naylor, Lily Wood, Richard Abbas, Margaret Malpass, Mark Bolton, and Susan Prophet. In faith we pray.
We pray to you, our Lord.
Here where we join our praises with the whole company of heaven, listen as we pray for all who have trusted Christ's promise to raise us up on the last day, those who eat his flesh and drink his blood. And we remember those who have recently died: Hazel Herrington, Carol Sims, Kathleen Miller, Patrick Elmore, Stuart Buckingham, Patricia Smalley, Joan Buxton, and Neville Elcock. In faith we pray.
We pray to you, our Lord.
Lord, satisfy our hunger with the food that lasts, the bread of God which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Please stand as you are able for the peace. We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a safe sign of peace.
Thank you. your grace, and restored in the image and likeness of the risen Christ. Therefore, earth unites with heaven to sing a new song of praise. We too join with angels and archangels as they proclaim your glory without end. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
You are holy indeed, the source of all holiness.
because I want to be quick, I'm going to go and get changed, come back and start the meeting. So if you want to leave now, you can. I'm not going to make you stay. But hope you all have a nice week if I don't see you all. Bye.